and a candidate of the Young Progressive Party, Ifeanyi Uba, has also cast his ballot. He voted at polling unit 20 in Otolo Ward 1 in Nnewi Town. Senator Uba is happy with the turnout of voters, but not with the slow accreditation process.
So good, but there's delay in materials coming to the polling units, and we need to look at it. We have some challenges, we have some reports, and I want to address that. The most important thing is to appreciate people coming in, people choking in the mass. You can see, I don't think we can have what they call apathy from this polling unit. And people are here to vote. We have some little challenges with the parameters, and I hope we will resolve it. In my own, it took some time, but it was settled out. There's no further apathy from my own understanding in this my polling unit. And we had a bit of issue with the biometrics, but we settled that out.
And Plus TV Africa's Marianne O'Connor is once again joining us all the way from Anambra State, where the state election is happening, to give us updates. Marianne, good afternoon.
Hi, good afternoon.
So where are you now presently, and what can you tell us?
Well, I moved from Amobia Ward 1 to Ward 2, and now I'm in Amobia Ward 3. And it seems more likely that every single ward has three different polling units. I'm in Ward 3 now. As you can see behind me, there's still a long line of people who are yet to vote, register and get their vote in. Now, I'd just like to quickly bring up to see that where we've gone to and what's happening in those wards. In Ward 3, most of the polling units visited have people sitting there idly because the equipment and the machines that are supposedly for the captain are not working. We met a former DSP who said that he had tried to vote 6 times. He tried to get accredited 6 times, and the captain machine did not get his We also went to another polling unit where people said they've been here since 10 a.m. in the morning. They've only had 15 people able to vote. They have had sometimes can be accepted by the machine, but then when it comes to the biometrics, it proves very difficult. So they feel very disenfranchised, and some of them have even gotten angry and left to their different homes, which means one way or the other, these people may not necessarily be able to vote. Now, when I asked some of the INEC officials what they're doing about this, they did say that they've spoken to the head office, and that the machines were supposedly on their way, but it's been hours up until now. There's not necessarily been any change.
Okay, so do you think that it's still possible for those equipment to get to those polling units and for the election to still happen?
It would only take a stroke of luck or a miracle, because it's about 3 minutes past two, and elections supposedly are to end at 2:30. But I do have party agents at this ward who are also angry at the fact that angry at the slow process in which the voting is taking, and they feel that many people may live here unable to vote.
All right, so right now, what can you tell us that we've not heard before concerning this election happening right now in Anambra State?
Sorry, can you take that question again?
We may not have heard about the ongoing Anambra election.
Well, I'm sure that you have heard, we have heard that the government superintendent in May had voted. He had cast his vote, and voting is going ongoing, even though there have been rumors that, the unrest in Onitsha, that maybe a lot of people are not being allowed to vote. But I think that that is not necessarily the case in May. We hear that it's safe right now to vote in May. People are still casting their votes. We're waiting to hear from former Governor PRB's ward. We're also trying to hear from other candidates' ward and the polling units what's going on there. And like I said, subsequently, I will keep updating you. But then we have some people here from the ward who would like to speak with us and let us know what the experience has been Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
What's your name, please?
My name is Stephen. I'm from
Mr. Moses, can you tell me what the experience has been?
Okay. The problem is that the people out
The turnout was massive, but so what's the last 30 minutes and then after that it's not functioning?
Then after some time, maybe 6 weeks to another 30 minutes, that's what we know.
Every 30 minutes, the machine stopped malfunctioning, and so it makes the process slow. And this is something that I have told you is being recorded in other polling units. He's saying that aside from that, the voting has been peaceful. People have come out early, but unfortunately, not many people have been able to pass their vote. So far, what's the percentage of people who've been able to pass their vote?
70% has been able to pass.
Oh, well, that's a good thing. He said about 70% of the voters have been able to pass their vote, so the other 30% will be hoping and hope to be able to pass their vote. So thank you very much for speaking with us. All right.
Thank you so much, Maryam, for this update. We'll come back to you to get more updates to find out if the voters in this particular unit were able to cast their vote.
Hello. Hope you enjoyed the news. Please do subscribe to our YouTube channel and don't forget to hit the notification button so you get notified about fresh news updates.